So what's up YouTube? So today we have a special guest in our studio who is my brother, who is a tech guy and also a YouTuber.
Hey, hello.
Okay, so here is he.
My name is Pranshu and today we are both going to show best budget phones from 6,000 to 20,000. So
okay, so as you heard, and I will link his channel at the end of the video, so you could find him easily. Okay, so click that icon and you would straight away jump in his channel. Okay, and please do subscribe his channel too for latest technology type news or facts.
Yeah, facts. Yes. So let's get started.
Okay, so without further ado, let's straight away jump into this video. Okay, the first one in our list is the Redmi. What is it?
Redmi 5A.
Oh, yeah. He got it right. Okay, so this is the Redmi 5A. Okay, so Pranshu, please tell what is the price of this device?
This phone is priced at 599.
Oh, wow. And I have not reviewed a single phone of Xiaomi, and in his channel you would find a lot of tech about Xiaomi phones and a lot of new facts and features. Even that one video of his was the screenshot one, or I don't know, or that was a hack, and that video was so good. Actually, that video was the first video which I saw on his channel. Yeah, he didn't told me that he has a channel, because he said that I want to become little bit big YouTuber, and then I want to show you. Okay, so first one is the Redmi 5A. Okay, so Pranshu, what's the specifications and main highlight of this phone?
This phone is on top of our list just because it is priced at 599, as I mentioned. And second thing is, this phone is on top of our list just because, as it mentioned, the price 599. Why I'm telling it again? Because this is the beast in its price. It is powered by the Snapdragon 425 and a 5-inch HD display, which is great at that price. And one thing I like about the Xiaomi phones, the MIUI. The MIUI is, all we know, that very optimized and utilized UI. And it is coming with the MIUI 9, which is lightning fast, as claimed by the Xiaomi. So it makes a very make sense on this our list. So Jay, what is your opinion about that?
Okay, so Pranshu, my opinion, as you mentioned all the specification, is that this phone is really great. This phone is really great for its price department. Okay, and the back of this device, Pranshu, man, I am impressed with the back of this device, because this one is a metal device and full metal design, which is superb. Considering the price department,
I am to correct Jay that it is a metal design, but not fully metal. It is one thing to note that it is made up of plastic, but gives a metal feel. As you can see in the pictures, it is very matte and very glossy, I would say.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh man.
But how clean is the bag?
This was not in the script or anything. I am really impressed that this one is plastic. I was not expecting that this one is plastic. I was expecting that this one is having a metal back or aluminium back. I was not expecting.
But consider the price. It is only about 6K. But
that's why I was surprised that the price of this device and the metal back, that's why I was so surprised. That's why, really. Okay, so tell your opinions by YouTube viewers.
This one is, as I mentioned, powered by Snapdragon 425 and a 3000 mAh battery, which is a very huge battery. And the display of the device is very bright and neat, as you can see. And the brightness is at 500 nits, and the sharpness and the color accuracy you can see in the picture how boldly it is mentioned. See how it is, and why, and this is why it is top the list of our budget segment.
Okay, so Pranshu, what is the next one in our list?
And the phone coming on next our list, it is the K8 Plus, Lenovo K8 Plus.
Oh, okay. So as I know about this one, I am in love, really. This one is a pretty good device. And this one is having a pretty dope camera, man. The pictures this one take is awesome. Because this one has a dual camera and dual flashlight. Flashlight is an additional features. And this one is powered by an P60? MediaTek Helio P60, really. P60.
You're getting wrong. It is Helio P23. One thing to note that it is the MediaTek Helio P23, which is also a great processor. And the camera my bro has mentioned earlier, it is very beast like a camera. And it shoots the very dope pictures. And the second camera is used for a depth enabled, or you would say a portrait mode, which is normal nowadays, and very much you can see on the high end devices like the iPhone 8 Plus and the 10, but they are giving at the budget segment. That's why we fall in love with this phone. So Jeff, what's your opinion about that?
Okay, so Pranshu, my opinion on this one is pretty great, because of course this one is a budget device, and this one really, Pranshu, this is plastic or metal?
No, this is a purely metal phone.
What is the cost of this device?
The cost of this phone is 999, and at this price, this is very worth. What you are getting is a 5.3 inch Full HD display. Yes, this is the display, and a pure stock Android experience, which is the best thing I like about these phones. As you can see, a front-facing flash and the touch-type capacitive buttons. The Android you are getting in this phone is the Android 7.1.1, but the company has promised to release a Oreo update for these phones.
So Pranshu, I am really impressed with your review, because the amount of features you actually mentioned was so great that I'm gonna shift with this phone, really.
Yeah, this is a cool phone. I would also fall in love.
Okay, so this was
our second phone.
Okay, so what's the third phone?
Okay, so our third phone is also from Lenovo, and as you can see, it is a K6 Note. It was a earlier generation of the K8 Note. We have not mentioned K8 Note because the K8 Plus is much better offering from the Lenovo, which is slightly less in price with the K8 Note. But coming to the K6 Note, it is a very cool device. It comes with the 5.5 inch Full HD display, and it would cost around
Pranshu, it's 10,599.
But the phone is very good in its price. It comes with an outstanding camera and the Snapdragon 435 performance. You can check it out after the K8 Plus, which is a very great device.
And all the phones which we are mentioning is down in the description.
Can check it out.
Okay. So,
coming to our fourth phone. The fourth phone is, and firstly, you can see the back. The back is very neat also.
And it is inspired by Redmi Note 4.
But we can tell that it is much better than the Redmi Note 4. It comes with a Dolby Atmos sound.
Okay.
As you can see, Lenovo branding. The fourth phone is
Zenfone Max Pro M1. And this one is pretty great. This one is coming around 12,999. And this one is coming by 18:9 ratio display. And this 18:9 ratio display, as you can see, and this one has a full HD plus resolution display, and this one is having a superb camera, which is awesome, like orientation like iPhone X, and the aluminium is aluminium 6000, which was earlier used in iPhone 6, and now it is reused and reused in this one. And here's the ASUS branding, and here's the fingerprint scanner, and here's the flashlight, here's the dual rear camera, which is used for depth sensing. And I don't know why dual camera phones are not offering optical zoom. Okay, so let me zoom. Okay, so I don't know why the companies are not offering optical zoom and option depth sensing. Depth sensing is good, but you can also find it in Google Mod camera. Okay, so this is the processor of this one is Snapdragon 636 Android, and this one is having an Android Audio on board. And as the company has said us that the company will give us an Android P update to this one. Okay, so moving on to our fourth phone.
No, yeah, it is our fifth phone.
Oh man. Okay, sorry Pranshu.
No.
Now the next one is the bummer.
Redmi Note 5 Pro,
man.
Which is very I would say similar to the Asus phone, but the offerings.
Okay,
so
as I know about this one, the specifications are same. Which I have said you in last phone, same specification continues here, really. Yes, Pranshu?
Yes, but the thing we have mentioned it here because the MIUI optimization, and it comes with a 6GB RAM model which cost around 16,000. That's why we have mentioned, so you can check it out. Okay.
And links will be down in description below.
Yes. Okay.
So moving on to our sixth one. This one is my favorite, man. This one is having a notch display. That's why it is not my favorite, because notch iPhone X.
But yeah, like but still the but the notch is I would say a future, so that's why companies are giving away. Okay, now coming to the phone, it is the F7, and it is
okay, so the F7, this one is having a 25 megapixel camera and Helio P60, and this one is having an full top to bottom display, not bottom chin. But then also this one is a beast, and back there is a single camera, flashlight, Oppo branding,
and
fingerprint scanner,
body.
And glass body. Wireless charging is not here. Really.
One thing to know. But no, I'm not very upset for this wireless charging function, because it is normal to see it in the mid-range phones. But the Oppo is Oppo F7 is very I would say a very hefty phone, because it is very solid in build.
Yeah, and it is heavy also, because this one is coming in around 153 grams.
Okay, so this completes our list of the budget phones.
And I know I haven't covered all the phones in our list, but that was the phone that I want to cover. Oh, sorry. I have discovered and I like that phone, and I'm not into it. And I will make a refresh video next month, and stay tuned for that. And if you do like end of this video, hit a thumbs up. And as I said, here's my brother. Please click here to subscribe his channel. Click here to subscribe my channel. And click here to see my last video. Okay, so this completes the review. So thank you for watching our video. Till then,
please subscribe.
Peace out and
subscribe.